unification of the forces is essential to build a new theory. And that's a fundamental property in physics, that all the forces are united. What is not united are the fields. Fields are acting very differently than forces. Fields, what we know about it, is very little. We know that it is a property of space. We know that an electric field is a special property of space. We know that a magnetic field is a special property of space. And we know that a gravitational field is a very special property of space. But what is space? Einstein suggested that space is just empty. It's no medium, it's not made of anything, it's just pure emptiness. But that's a little bit comparable with the goldfish on a bowl who does not realize that he's in the water because he's just floating in it. And that is in fact what we are, like a goldfish in a bowl. A little bit beautiful, expressed by John Congers in the 60s, but it is what it is. We have no idea about vacuum because we have never been pulled out of vacuum. We don't know how it would be without vacuum. We are surrounded by it, and that's why we assume that it doesn't exist. But it's a little weird that vacuum has all kinds of properties. It is a property of electric field, a property of magnetic field, a property of gravitational field. It has a permeability, it has a permittivity. And even if you create an electric field, vacuum gets a weight. You can really put it on a very sensitive scale and it gets weight according E is mc squared. So vacuum has affected everything what we know from the real world. And we still cannot understand that it's a building material. Vacuum is a building material of this world. And we will never understand vacuum until we are able to create a space without vacuum. Nikola Tesla was speaking about it. He was suggesting that applying the exact and the right frequencies, it was possible to create holes in the vacuum. And that is something beyond our scientific world nowadays, but maybe something of the future. For now, we just assume that we have, and that's really true, no idea about what an electric field is, only that it's a property of vacuum. A magnetic field, yes, it's a property of vacuum, and the gravitational field also. Maybe it has something to do with a distortion of vacuum, but how can you disturb something when it doesn't exist? So it's very likely that vacuum is something real. It's probably the building material of our universe, of this reality. But all that we know is when it's completely been distorted, then it becomes visible in our world, when there's interaction. And that is what we're speaking about. This film now, we will speak about the unification of the forces, because fields can only interact with corresponding fields. And interaction with corresponding fields is electric is electric, magnetic is magnetic, and gravitational is gravitational. But when it has transformed into a force, all the forces can act together. And all the forces together, the forces originating from electric fields, the forces originating from magnetic fields, the forces originating from gravitational fields, they all cooperate, work together, and form a perfect equilibrium. Also the force of inertia. What inertia is, we will come to that later, but the forces created by inertia, what is in fact nothing else but confined energy, these forces together always have to be zero in every direction. And because space is not located at one point, we always have to speak about the force densities expressed in newton per cubic meters. And the force densities always have to equal zero in every direction, at every location, at every time. And this equation looks different than what it represents, because it looks like this is the interaction between two magnetic fields, the field intensity H, but it is in fact Coulomb's law, the interaction between a charged particle moving relative to a magnetic field and being deflected. This is in fact that by the motion of the electric particle, the electric field around the particle has been transformed into a magnetic field. And it looks like the interaction between two magnetic fields, but it represents the interaction between an electric particle and a magnetic field. And this is a fundamental aspect of the Lorentz transformations, that electric fields appear like magnetic fields and magnetic fields appear like electric fields due to relative velocity. And this equation is in fact now what we need to find the total force for the total interaction between electric fields, magnetic fields and the inertia of fields. And we have to realize that we're talking about something we do not know what it is, because nobody in the whole scientific world knows what an electric field is. It is a property of space, that's all we can say about it. A magnetic field is a property of space, but that's all we can say about it. And a gravitational field is a property of space, that's all that we can say about it. But we have no idea, in fact, what this vacuum, what we call vacuum, is. Is it something like, according Einstein's suggestion, that space is empty, it's just nothing? But how is it possible that something that doesn't exist, that is nothing, has all kinds of properties, has a permittivity, has a permeability, has fields, electric fields, magnetic fields, gravitational fields, and it is like we're speaking about a world we do not understand, and it's exactly what we do here in science. We speak about things we do not understand, but Newton had the power to at least observe the universe, learn from it, and express it into simple equations. And in fact, his second law of motion is not Newton's law of motion, it's nature's law of motion. Newton just observed it and wrote it down. And what is for us a powerful aspect is that from the world we do not understand, the world of fields, electric fields, magnetic fields, gravitational fields, by interaction these fields are transformed into forces, and forces is something from Newton's world, is something from nature, is something we all know. Everybody knows about the force. Everybody sometimes banged into something and felt the force. The force is something that we can feel. The force is something which is part of our reality. And because it is part of our reality, it interacts in all kinds of ways. When we go back to equation 4 in the book, we see Newton's third law, which has been expressed as electric forces plus magnetic forces minus the inertia forces. Using Einstein's relationship between energy and mass, E=mc², we can express the inertia of electromagnetic radiation by the last term, 1 divided by the square of the speed of light and the time differentiation of the Poynting vector, expressed in Newton per cubic meter. On top, we see the force density expressed in Newton per cubic meters for Newton's second law of motion. The inertia term has been expressed by the Poynting vector, which also can be written as the cross product between the electric field intensity and the magnetic field intensity. We found already Coulomb's force, which is indicated as the first term E times the divergence of the electric field intensity E. The second term expresses the motion of an electric charged particle with a relative velocity v to a magnetic field. Because of this relative movement, the electric field around the electric particle has been visible in this transformation as a magnetic field. And both magnetic fields interact with each other, but the movement of an electric charged particle is in fact the origin of this process. We have to realize that it's a Lorentz transformation of an electric field into a magnetic field, and for this reason both equations are being written in red, because red indicates that the origin is electrical. Because there is a symmetry, a perfect symmetry between electric fields and magnetic fields, there should also be an equal term for the transformation of a magnetic particle moving relative to an electric field, which has been expressed as the blue term, the fourth term of this equation. We see in red identical the same terms and the same expressions and the same operators as in blue. In fact, there are two processes here expressed. One process is directly Coulomb's law interaction between two electric fields, and the terms expressing the curl factors expressing the transformed electric field into a magnetic field in red, and the transformed magnetic field into an electric field expressed in blue.